Contrary to popular and totally ignorant belief, many animals see the world at least as well, and some see it very much better than us humans. Of course, reality is always subjective, but as far as sensory input goes, our image of the world is actually far less complete than many animals that we see as subordinate. In the video today, we're looking at 10 radically different ways that other Earthlings see the Earth. Number 10. Giant clams live in a world of colorful blobs. You might not have seen them, but snails actually do have eyes, one on each of their upper tentacles or antennae. They use these to make out forms from a short distance away, then as they get up close to them, they'll reach out with their feelers, the lower short tentacles, to learn more about what they've discovered. In fact, sight is so important for getting around that snails actually have light-sensitive cells all over their bodies, allowing them to see shadows falling at virtually any angle. Adult giant clams, another type of mollusk, are by contrast completely immobile, so we might expect them to see nothing at all. As it turns out, however, they're equipped with hundreds of tiny pinhole eyes. These are cup-like cavities with narrow lensless apertures. They're able to identify forms, but giant clams have an interesting advantage over snails. They appear to have color vision. We can only imagine what they see in their 100-plus years underwater, but researchers think that it may be a panoply of psychedelic lights, colorful blobs indicating potential predatory movement, and warning the clam to squirt water in defense. Number 9. Sharks see more than we think. It's long been assumed that sharks have poor eyesight, but only because their other senses are so good. They can, for instance, detect subtle chemical changes equivalent to a single drop of blood in a million drops of water, and they can hear very low frequency infrasonic sounds. They also have extraordinarily sophisticated pressure sensors. These are essentially pores that map their surroundings. And further, they can also sense electric fields, possibly allowing them to migrate based on geomagnetic field lines, and certainly allowing them to sense bioelectrical signals from their prey. As it turns out, however, their eyesight is top-notch too, it just isn't that important to them. Not only can sharks see in almost all directions at once, thanks to the placement of their eyes on their heads, they can also see up to 10 times better than us in clear water. Dark or murky water isn't a problem either, and they can see pretty well even without taking the other senses into account, all of which combines to make sharks incredibly effective predators. Number 8. Jumping spiders see better than us. Despite having up to 8 eyes, most spiders don't see very well. Often they're only really able to tell the difference between light and dark, relying instead on touch, for example vibrations, and taste to get around. Even those that can presumably make out forms are thought to only see low-res impressions of what they're looking at because of the relatively coarse-grained mosaics of receptor cells that make up their retinas. But there is at least one notable exception, and that's the jumping spider. Not only does it see in high resolution through its largest forward-facing pair of eyes, the others being for peripheral vision and motion detection, but it can actually see more colors than we can, including those in the ultraviolet range. They also appear to have some intelligence traits of larger animals, such as forward planning and abstract thinking, both of which are important for a predator that preys on other predators. Specifically, jumping spiders are able to visualize and retain a mental image of where their prey might be hiding to plan out its route and then surprise it. Rather unnervingly, researchers testing this ability were careful to keep themselves hidden from the arachnids because, as they noted, jumping spiders are attracted to blinking. Number 7. Vipers, pythons, and boas see heat. Snakes are generally thought to see combinations of just two colors, green and blue, although some nocturnal species also see ultraviolet. Species that hunt during the day, however, often filter blue and ultraviolet light out, a little like they're wearing sunglasses, which is why their eyes can appear yellow. Either way, with the possible exception of the cobra, snake vision is thought to be blurry. To compensate for this, many snakes, especially the nocturnal species, are able to see infrared. Humans and other animals can perceive this range of the spectrum, but most of the time only as heat. By contrast, snakes may actually render mental images of their surroundings based on infrared radiation, heat signatures, in other words, of hazards and prey. Vipers, pythons, and boas receive these signals from up to a meter away through their pit organs. These are holes between the nostrils and eyes that are activated by temperatures over 28 degrees Celsius. Needless to say, a snake's eye view of the world is worlds apart from the one that we know, and it's easy to see why they're so good at hunting. In fact, this natural infrared detection is thought to be the best on the planet, far better than even our most advanced technology. Number 6. Box jellyfish see all. Most jellyfish have pretty basic vision, usually limited to light-sensitive cells that help orient them relative to the sky. The box jellyfish, however, has 24 eyes, each serving one of four different purposes. They've also got brains that are capable of giving them an unprecedented 360-degree view of the world. This is perhaps unfortunate for other species, given its reputation as the world's most venomous creature. One set of eyes detects obstacles, helping box jellies to swim as well as they do, making rapid 180-degree turns as they traverse the ocean floor. Other eyes detect the visual properties of whatever they meet. While most of these eyes hang at varying levels from the body, four are constantly fixed, not just upward, but actually at a point beyond the water's surface, such as the canopy of their mangrove swamp habitats. No matter which way the jellyfish is facing, crystal-weighted stalks ensure that these four eyes always look up, which is vital for navigating to and from their homes among the mangrove roots. Number 5. Bees see hidden patterns in petals. There are many remarkable things about bees, not least about their vision in particular. For one thing, they navigate based on the position of the sun without actually having to see it. As long as there's sunlight getting through the clouds, even on an overcast day, bees are able to compute a homing vector by the distance flown in each direction relative to the layout of polarized rays, effectively vertical pillars of light. This allows them to cover great distances and always return to their hives. And when they get there, they might communicate the route through way of their famous waggle dance. Bees can also see in color, which might be surprising at first, until you consider that flowers evolve to be as attractive as possible to their pollinators. In fact, bees are privy to a beauty in flowers that humans are simply unable to see. Like us, they perceive three basic colors, but instead of red, green, and blue, they see blue, green, and ultraviolet. This allows them to see striking UV patterns on petals. These patterns evolve to help bees find the nectar right away and might therefore be arranged as targets in concentric circles or precisely placed dots telling the bee where to stick its tongue. Bees actually have five eyes, three simple ones, or ocelli, on the top of their heads, and two larger eyes, each with many thousands of lenses or facets. As a result of their excellent vision, bees' color perception is the fastest of any species on the planet, and they can easily distinguish between individual flowers in a group, no matter how tightly they're packed together. So much for the so-called humble bee. This animal's cutting-edge evolutionary supremacy reflects its central importance to the well-being of many other species. Number 4. Migratory birds see the planet's magnetic field. Birds can see ultraviolet too, but not at the expense of red light. Whereas humans have just three types of cone cells, allowing us to see the world in red, green, and blue, a lot of birds have four types: red, green, blue, and ultraviolet. As tetrachromats, they see up to 99 million more colors than we can, and thanks to a special oil drop filter in each cone cell, they're much faster at distinguishing between them. Naturally, this helps birds forage for seeds, berries, fruits, and insects. It also helps some birds, like the vole-hunting European kestrel, to spot UV reflections from urine trails. But superior color perception is far from the extent of their prowess. Many birds also see the planet's magnetic field. Based on studies of robins and zebra finches, researchers believe that cryptochromes, a class of blue light-sensitive eye protein, convey a sense of magnetoreception to these and other migratory birds. It's unknown exactly how the magnetic field appears, but it may be as a band of light or blue trail, a kind of filter on their regular vision that helps them navigate the globe. Number 3. Donkeys have almost 360-degree vision. While ambush predators, like cats, foxes, and crocodiles, i.e. those that stalk their prey and strike at close range as opposed to chasing it down, tend to have vertical slit pupils, grazing prey, like donkeys, horses, goats, and sheep, have horizontal slits instead. Vertical slits help judge distance with minimal maneuvering of the head, whereas horizontal slits receive light from a much wider field of view, allowing grazers to see almost all the way around them at once, or up to 350 degrees. Humans, meanwhile, are forced to make do with 120 degrees. To put this in perspective, imagine you're a beach donkey, which is totally a real thing in Britain, facing out towards the sea. With a 350-degree of vision from the eyes on the sides of your head, you'll be able to not only see the horizon right ahead of you, but all the way around to the beach on either side and much of the inland behind you as well. Your only blind spots would be two rather negligible zones directly in front of you and behind your head. Furthermore, as you tilt your head towards the ground, your view would remain much the same thanks to a mutation called cyclovergence, the rotation of your eyes in the sockets to keep your pupils forever parallel to the ground. Needless to say, horizontal pupils help to spot predators in the wild. Indeed, they're so useful for prey animals that they evolved independently in a number of unrelated species, including mongooses, flying frogs, and octopi. Our circular pupils, meanwhile, help us to see detail in bright light, which comes in handy for foraging as well as using computers, and explains why squirrels and birds have them too. But they also help with chasing down as opposed to stalking prey, which is why they're found in dogs as well. Cuttlefish, incidentally, have W-shaped pupils, which are thought to balance vertically uneven light fields in their habitat. Number 2. Bats and dolphins see sound. Bats are popularly thought to be blind, but actually they see quite well. In low-light conditions, such as dawn or dusk, they may see even better than us. Bouncing high-frequency shrieks off their surroundings and prey, bats analyze echoes within milliseconds, gauging the timing, direction, and frequency of return signals to map their environment in detail and pounce on their prey with precision. Although echolocating microbats do not rely on their eyes as much as non-echolocating megabats, for example fruit bats and flying foxes, they do nevertheless use them for social interaction, to watch for predators, and to assist with navigation. Actually, since their echolocation range is approximately 33 to 66 feet, they need their eyes to see anything outside of that. Dolphins use echolocation too, of course, and because sound travels faster in water, they're thought to be more efficient than bats. Some researchers even believe that dolphins use echolocation to communicate in a sonopictorial form of language, the exchange of holographic acoustic images as opposed to merely symbolic sounds to refer to objects, places, and perhaps even abstract ideas. Number 1. Time is completely relative. It's common knowledge that animal lifespans vary, but so does their perception of time. It all depends on how quickly they process sensory input. Researchers tested this by flashing a light at different frequencies and measuring different animals' brain activity with electrodes. Some animals were capable of seeing the light blink on and off at frequencies so high that humans only see it as a constant light. In other words, these animals see the world in what we would call slow motion, or maybe bullet time. This is important for both predators and prey out in the wild, but crucially, it's not a trick they deploy on commands before returning to time as we know it. Rather, time actually passes at a different rate for them. The implications of this are very interesting. Dogs, for instance, take in visual information 25% faster than humans, which makes television appear as a series of flickering images to them. Flies take in visual information a whopping 400% faster, which is why they find it so easy to avoid being swatted, because as far as they're concerned, the swatter comes down at a snail's pace, or at least what appears to be a snail's pace to them. Generally speaking, the smaller an animal is, the faster its metabolism and the slower time passes for it. Interestingly, this appears to hold true even for animals of the same species, such as children and adult humans. If you ever wondered why time goes so much quicker as you get older, well, maybe this is it. So I really hope you found that video interesting. If you did, please do hit that thumbs up button below, and don't forget to subscribe. We've got brand new videos just like this every day of the week. And if you're looking for something else to watch right now, why not check out my other channel called Biographics? You'll find some links to that on the screen now. And as always, thank you for watching.